Time for an update on the box turtle kit. Again, this is a beta version of the kit that is coming from LDO. As you can see, I now have the box turtle put together. It's up on its legs. These will go into the extrusions of the V2.4 that this is going to live on at the shop. Let me give you a little bit of a tour around where things are right now. So here on the back of the box turtle, we have the output from the hub, and you'll get a better look at that in a moment. This is the cooling fan for the electronics, and this is the connector that I'm going to use to get the signal and power from the printer into the box turtle. I think I mentioned in the first video that the beta kit didn't ship with this wire, so I'm using a combination of things that we have at the shop and some parts that I have kicking around here in my garage. So this is a quick disconnect made by a company called CN Linko. You can find those on Amazon and on AliExpress. It terminates in a plug like this, so it's got a nice positive latch, and it will do the job very well. What we're going to do is use some of the wiring from a Nighthawk tool head board, because there's a good multi-conductor cable as well as some other features that will make this easy to hook up. We're going to use this adapter board from the LDO Motors Nighthawk USB toolhead board kit. We have power input and USB input, and then a Molex 6-pin output on the other side. So I'll use the cable from the Nighthawk kit to get power and signal up to the box turtle and then terminate it in that connector. Let's take a look at what's happening under the shell. So if we look at the underside, we have our four extruders here, all of them output through these PTFE tubes into the hub. We have the AFC light board here at the bottom. That is the controller for everything. So looking at the system in place, rather than the way I just showed you in the last video, I'm going to start feeding in filament. And once you get to a point, you have to move the trigger, which you can see there. That releases a micro switch there that tells the system that you are loading filament. That will start the extruder, so that as the filament comes through the PTFE tube, which hopefully you can see is coming through here, the extruder will already be moving. It'll grab that filament and then feed it through. That will come here and then go to the hub. So the trigger switch will start the system. There's a filament load switch that in the extruder that will tell the system that the extruder has successfully pulled the filament through. Then there is another switch here in the hub that will let the system know that filament has made it that far. And here is the output side of that CN Linko connector. I've got my power wires coming over to the power input to the system here on this 4-pin Molex. That would also be where CAN would be run if we're using CAN connections. We are not going to use CAN, we're going to use USB on this build. So I've connected a USB-C connector to that CN Linko to pick up the data lines for that. There is a base plate available to print for the box turtle. Obviously that's not going to work well with this USB-C connector sticking out here. I've been told that this connector will be moved during production, so that you will be able to put the base plate on. Honestly, I'm not too concerned about it because this is all DC voltage. If this was a build where we had an internal power supply, where we had mains AC voltage coming in, then I would absolutely want to enclose this with a base plate for safety. But since we're just pulling DC power from the printer, I feel it's relatively safe to have this unenclosed, especially because we are going to be bolting this to the printer. So hopefully we are smart enough to turn the power off and disconnect the power from the box turtle before we undo the screws to remove this from the printer for service. There's one more component involved before the filament gets to your tool head, and that is the turtleneck filament buffer. This is the turtleneck. It has two micro switches here that can tell if this slider is in that position or that position. And the system uses this to help synchronize the extruders in the box turtle with the extruder in your tool head. So at this point, the majority of the hardware is done. There's a couple little wiring things that I have to finalize. I'm going to put a disconnect in the wiring for the turtleneck to make it easier to remove the box turtle from the printer if we have to do maintenance or anything on either the box turtle or the printer. And from there, it's flashing the AFC light board, installing the extension into Clipper, and then we start doing some calibration and setup. We're also going to be installing the Filametrics filament cutter in the tool head. So we've still got a little ways to go, but we're getting there. Next time we should be looking at actually putting this beast on the machine and seeing what we can do. So thanks for watching. Stay tuned for the next one, and we will see you soon with more Box Turtle projects.